您好，我是光骑社的社长马绍阿基，欢迎您收看罗马主场 Rome Report。 本周的新闻重点包括教宗接见200多名耶稣会士，这是庆祝耶稣会社会正义与生态秘书处成立50周年的会议，而这一个会议的目的是交流经验，并且提高人们对宗教团体作为致力服务弱势群体的关注。首先我们就来看成立于1969年的耶稣会社会正义与生态秘书处正好届满50周年，当时耶稣会的总会长雅鲁培神父成立这一个内部组织，希望能够协调和帮助耶稣会的社会工作项目。而现任的耶稣会总会长苏萨神父表示，全球社会状况并没有改善，实际上还比50年前更糟糕。
In 1969, Father Arupe, who was then the Superior General of the Jesuits, launched an internal organization to coordinate and help the Society of Jesus's social projects, the Social Justice and Ecology Secretariat. More than 210 Jesuits, activists, and experts have gathered in Rome to celebrate its 50th anniversary.Its objective is to exchange experiences and raise awareness as its role as a religious congregation dedicated to service of the most disadvantaged.
I think that the world's social situation is not better, but actually worse than it was 50 years ago. This week, we want to remember what we've learned in the past 50 years. We want to give thanks for all the lives that have been dedicated with enthusiasm, including the lives that have been martyred for this.
The participants in this Congress coordinate social activities of Jesuits all over the world. They cover various problems from discrimination to caste problems in India, or the abandonment women suffer in poor or fighting countries.
Let me give you a fact. Last year in Latin America, 60,000 women died simply because they're women. Most of these cases are uninvestigated.
The Hindu religion, it has stratified the people by different castes.Now, what happened is that it's been very deeply ingrained in all the minds of all the people.
The Congress highlighted the Jesuits and lay collaborators that have been killed for working to help the disadvantaged. Father Arturo Sosa said between all of them, there is a cause for a canonization that could be concluded within a short amount of time.
Father Rutilo Grande's cause is already in the last phase of the canonical process. We are hoping that for the 30th anniversary of El Salvador martyrs, Father Rutilo would already be canonized, but he will be soon.
The meeting has a theme, a journey of justice and reconciliation, 50 years and beyond. It's an opportunity to analyze achievements and failures of the past, as well as the present situation and dream of future projects.One of the ideas being promoted is to encourage collaboration with other institutions, Catholic or not, to create a more powerful network to benefit the disadvantaged. The participants in the meeting will meet with Pope Francis on Thursday and close the Congress on Friday.
接着我们就来看教宗方济各11月初接见超过200名前来罗马参加会议的耶稣会士。教宗重新提到全球正处于第三次世界大战，而这个大战零零碎碎的在发生，而我们必须彻底的改变思考模式来促进和平的对话。
Pope Francis met with more than 200 participants in a Congress organized by the Society of Jesus. It's about the meeting, a journey of justice and reconciliation. It was organized to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the department in charge of coordinating and promoting its social apostolate, the Social Justice and Ecology Secretariat. The Superior General of the Jesuits, Arturo Sosa, addressed the Pope at the beginning of the meeting.
Lo más importante de este Congreso...es ver con claridad los caminos a recorrer en el futuro inmediato, en el mediano y largo plazo.
Pope Francis gave his speech in Spanish, where he repeated that the world is in a critical social situation.
Subsiste la trata de personas, abundan las expresiones de xenofobia y la búsqueda egoísta del interés nacional, las desigualdades entre países y en el interior de los mismos,crece sin que se encuentre remedio. con una progresión, yo diría, geométrica.
The Pope recalled that the world is in a World War III, fought in little pieces, and that a radical change of mentality is necessary to foster dialogue.
Necesitamos de una verdadera revolución cultural, una transformación de nuestra mirada colectiva, de nuestras actitudes, de nuestros modos de percibirnos y de situarnos ante el mundo.
The Pope ended his intervention recalling the message of Father Arupe, the Superior General of the Jesuits that instituted the Social Justice and Ecology Secretariat. He said that as Jesuits, they should not leave prayer behind, an indispensable instrument for their evangelical mission.
教宗方济各在最近一次的周三要礼讲授，谈到保禄宗徒的传教旅程中，有两位平信徒的角色很重要，他们是阿贵拉和普里史拉两夫妇。当年他们冒险让基督徒在自己的家聚集，教宗希望大家以这对基督徒夫妇为典范，反思平信徒在福音出传的重要角色。
Despite a gray and rainy day, the Pope went out and toured in St. Peter's Square to greet the pilgrims. In his address, the Pope recalled the important role of two lay people in St. Paul's evangelization. They were Aquila and Priscilla, who were exiled from Rome with the rest of the Jews by Emperor Claudius. The Pope said, unfortunately, the exile of the Jews is not a thing of the past.
E tutti eravamo convinto che questo era finito, ma oggi incomincia a rinascere qua, là, là, l'abitudine di perseguitare gli ebrei. Fratelli e sorelle, questo non è né umano né cristiano. Gli ebrei sono fratelli nostri e non vanno perseguitati. Capito?
Then Pope Francis recalled that Aquila and Priscilla risked a lot by allowing Christians to meet in their house.
Quante famiglie in tempo di persecuzione rischiano la testa per mantenere nascosti i perseguitati? Questo è il primo esempio.
Using this Christian couple as an example, the Pope reflected on the importance of the laity in early evangelization.
Pensate che il cristianesimo dall'inizio è stato predicato dai laici pure. Voi laici siete responsabili per il vostro battesimo di portare avanti la fede. Credo che ci siano i nuovi sposi. Ci sono? Ce ne sono lì? Eccoli. Ascoltate voi la vostra vocazione.
Finally, the Pope called for peace in Burkina Faso, recently hit by brutal terrorist attacks that cost the lives of hundreds of people.
Affido al Signore tutte le vittime, feriti, numerosi sfollati e quanti soffrono per questi drammi.
Burkina Faso is suffering under the weight of Islamic fundamentalism. That's why Pope Francis asked authorities to act according to the spirit of human fraternity, reflected in the document from Abu Dhabi.The Pope and the Imam of Al-Azhar, one of the main Sunni leaders of the Muslim world, signed that document. The two will meet again this Friday at the Vatican.
教宗方济各最近接见包容性资本主义议会的成员，这一个议会主要凝聚商人以及政治领袖，并且推动惠及所有人的经济。教宗方济各特别提到，全球贫穷的情况不断恶化，证明人与国家并没有和谐融合，反而不公大行其道。
The Pope met with the Council for Inclusive Capitalism. It is an organization that brings together business people and political leaders to promote an economy for the benefit of all people. Lady Lynn Forrester de Rothschild, the chief executive of the organization, explained the initiative to him.The Council looks for ways to spread the benefits of the capitalist system to everyone, not just the few.
L'aumento dei livelli di povertà su scala globale testimonia che la disuguaglianza prevale sull'integrazione armoniosa di persone e nazioni. È necessario e urgente un sistema economico giusto, affidabile e in grado di rispondere alle sfide più radicali che l'umanità e il pianeta si trovano ad affrontare.
That is why the Pope told them about the situation of the poor. According to Pope Francis, a healthy economic system cannot be based on short-term profit at the expense of long-term productive, sustainable and socially responsible development and investment.
Il vero sviluppo non può limitarsi alla sola crescita economica, ma deve favorire la promozione di ogni uomo e di tutto l'uomo. Un sistema economico privo di preoccupazioni etiche non conduce a un ordine sociale più giusto, ma porta invece a una cultura usa e getta dei consumi e dei rifiuti.
Before concluding, the Pope thanked them for their work to promote a more humane and fair economy that leaves no one behind.
有一项推动宗教及文化交流的展览最近在中座拉特朗大学揭幕，这项名为书法中的对话展览一共展出24幅书法作品，创作者是来自沙地阿拉伯的艺术家阿尔胡扎伊姆。教宗方济各不仅参加开幕式，同时也前往拉特朗大学礼堂和师生们谈话。目前拉特朗大学也正在筹划由教宗召开的全球教育公约会议，而这项会议将于2020年的5月举行。
Pope Francis went outside the Vatican walls to inaugurate the exhibition Calligraphy for Dialogue.Pontifical Lateran University. The exhibition aims for interreligious and cultural dialogue and is a tribute to Cardinal John Luis Taran. It consists of 24 pieces by an artist from Saudi Arabia, Othman Al-Khuzayam, who accompanied the Pope as he showed him his works of art. Then the Pope entered the main hall of the university, where he was welcomed with these words by the rector.The university is preparing for the Global Compact on Education for Peace, convened by the Pope for May 2020.
Grazie per questo momento che chiude la riflessione di una giornata dedicata ai temi dell'educazione, ai temi della pace, ai temi dei diritti fondamentali.
Pope Francis gave more details about why he decided to convene this World Day at the Vatican. He's invited people from various fields to the event, from professors to religious and political leaders.
Educare alla pace richiede di dare sollievo e risposta a coloro, molti purtroppo, che i conflitti e le guerre condannano a morte o costringono a abbandonare gli affetti, le abitazioni, i paesi d'origine.
Pope Francis explained that new generations need an education to learn how to communicate and live together.
Di fronte alla mancanza di pace, non basta invocare la libertà dalla guerra, proclamare diritti o anche utilizzare l'autorità nelle sue diverse forme. Occorre soprattutto mettersi in discussione. Recuperare la capacità di stare tra le persone.
In next year's May meeting, interreligious dialogue will play a fundamental role. That's why the Pope remembered Cardinal John Luis Taran. He was prefect of the Vatican Dicastery in charge of relations with other faiths. He died in 2018, and Pope Francis defined him as an example of a man who knew how to construct peace through dialogue.
位在梵蒂冈城内的博物馆每年参观人数将近有800万人，在这里有一位工作超过20年的博物馆掌门人，在他的手上保管2979把钥匙，让我们一起跟随掌门人的脚步，来用独特的视角参观梵蒂冈博物馆。
In the early morning hours, Johnny Crea is awake.To open up the Vatican museums for the thousands of tourists who visit daily. He is the Vatican Museum's key master. Beginning at 4:45 a.m., he coordinates the 5 people who open the museums in the morning and the 5 who close it around midnight. Yet he not only oversees the work, but walks 1 mile in the morning, opening up each of the doors and gates.Each door and key is numbered, ensuring that among the 2,979 keys, all are present.
Here we are. Next, we will continue and go towards the Chiaramonte Gallery.
However, after 21 years on this job, Johnny knows the keys like the back of his hand. One of the most spectacular parts of this job is being the first one to turn on the lights of the Sistine Chapel. He has the entire room all to himself before the tours begin.
I have the opportunity to open the Sistine Chapel for all the tourists that visit from around the world. So it's unique, extraordinary, and beautiful for me and also for my colleagues. We are also in the center of Christianity. So for a Catholic, it's more than you could ever want.
Every day he's able to admire the frescoes Michelangelo himself painted for 9 years in the early 16th century. It's not only this room which impacts him, but all the hallways and paintings remind him of history and the center of the Catholic Church. For example, this tapestry of the Resurrection of Christ, designed by Raphael, has Jesus' eyes follow him each morning as he makes his rounds. It's an artistic illusion that always intrigues tourists. Immediately after, he turns on the lights for yet another well-known hallway.
Here we are in the Gallery of Geographical Maps. It's one of the most beautiful galleries, hands down, that represents Italy through maps.
These 40 maps showing each Italian region were requested by Pope Gregory XII in 1580. They were designed by Ignazio Danti to fill the 400-foot hallway. Each aspect shows how art connects to faith, going from hallways and the gallery of statues to Raphael's rooms.
Here we are now in Raphael's rooms.
At the end of the early morning tour, he concludes with a rare view, only reserved for the key holders, looking out onto the Vatican. He can see all of Rome, but he says there's nothing like the museums.
Everything is beautiful in the museums. Every door, every part has a story to tell, has its uniqueness. Yet the Sistine Chapel always wins for its history and art. I believe in the Sistine Chapel, but in the museums in general, art has the power to unite everyone in the world.
This power is evident in how the number of tourists who come to the Vatican Museums has grown over the years. Crea asserts when he started more than 20 years ago, not even 2 million would come a year. Now that number has nearly quadrupled. It's a testimony to not only history and art, but to the Catholic faith that universally unites the global church.
感谢您收看这一周的罗马主场 Rome Report， 在节目最后带您一起来观赏光启社最新推出的节目 Oh My God 微笑福尔摩沙的精彩节目片段。我是马少阿基，我们下周再会，祝福大家平安喜乐。
他原本就是比较没有精神，对很多事情没有兴趣。接触到打击乐之后呢，他们就是非常的喜欢。其实对他们来讲是非常困难的，可是他们就是愿意学习。裴修女常常会来关心我们的团员，然后给他们鼓励、加油打气。然后我们要去表演，当时没有表演的服装，他们为我们制作一个表演的服装。
这些很有兴趣，小朋友要表演呢、要做什么的，我就给他们做服装。其实在我们家小时候是有一个古时代的，我妈妈常常用，我就跟她一起跟她学的嘛。做得越久也做得越好，也就是说一回生二回熟，就这样的。 在台湾的服务这么多年，在这里服务的也是我的荣幸。我觉得没有那个退休的细胞，我乐意服务一直到天主安排的那一天，叫我回我就可以了。